Ladies and gentlemen, his name, David Taylor.
You're looking at the baby-faced David Taylor. He may be baby-faced, but he's a three-time junior high state champion. David Taylor, kind of a wunderkind from freshman on.
Oh, good shot there by Taylor.
Nice.
Finish, and he does. But look across the mat at Taylor. You're certainly not going to be scared to death.
I think looks are a little deceiving. I don't think I'm, you know, as wimpy as I look.
I thought it was kind of cool when he was on the mat and he's like hitting his headgear like, oh my gosh, I really did this.
Pressure ever got to Taylor ever? I mean, he looked like this in sixth grade winning.
That was about the time that David just got hooked and he goes, Dad, I gotta do these.
Babyface David Taylor, because that's what we call him on the air.
Babyface Assassin's not gonna be around again.
That's right.
He's such a hard worker, and he just strives to be the best.
19 more score! Let's score, David!
As he entered his senior season, class of 2009, David Taylor had set an incredibly high bar. Would he win 4 national Ironman titles? Would he win 4 state titles? Would he win a showdown match with another 4-time state champion hopeful? And in a sport where wrestlers cut weight classes to gain advantage, would he do it all while catapulting an astonishing 4 weight classes?
Great wrestlers look good at every weight class.
I was going to say, I don't think it matters what weight class he chooses.
This is the story of one of the most accomplished wrestling careers in Ohio and even perhaps American high school history.
He's certainly in the top 5 of all time, I think.
He's 1 in 1,000, 1 in 1,000,000, 1 in 100,000,000, maybe.
The way he wrestles, that's like magic to me.
Try to understand. He's a magic man.
The magic man of the mat, David Taylor, the first 18 years. David Taylor's trip to the bright lights at the top of the high school wrestling world begins in an unlikely fashion.
He was on his back all the time, thinking it was funny looking up at the lights, which, you know, that's a big no-no in wrestling. And we just like shaking our heads going, okay.
Like many moms, Kathy was looking for something to keep her rambunctious 5-year-old son busy in the small town of a state known not for wrestling, but for its Wild West heritage, Yellowstone Park, and Old Faithful.
We were living in Evanston, Wyoming. It's a real small community. This community, I think, has maybe a population of 200, but it's a farm community, so it's spread out. Evanston had maybe 10 or 12,000. They had one high school, and the high school was having a wrestling club. And I looked at it in the paper, and I called my husband. I said, I'm going to sign him up, because David was a very hyper kid. There was nothing abnormal about him. He was just like, don't touch that, David. He'd touch this and go, hee. Don't touch that, David. He'd look at this and go, hee. He just, you know, he was just full of energy. And I didn't want to take that away from him, but I wanted to find something that's going to take that energy and put it into something positive. I took him there. David liked it. He was not very good.
His first year, I thought he absolutely stunk. He'll tell you he thought he stunk. I mean, he didn't win a tournament until his last event.
Last tournament of the year was actually at Evanston, and I won the tournament.
Once David felt the top step of the award stand and clutched the chart of a champion, he was captivated.
I remember saying, Dad, when's the next thing? And he's like, you know, season's over. And I was probably a little upset. I don't remember, probably because I liked the sport, and it's kind of crazy why I liked it, because I was so bad.
I said, David, that's the end of the year. He goes, no, there's got to be some more tournaments. So his desire was there, and that's when I started doing the videotapes, and I said, well, I'm going to have to work with him.
The work with his son would begin with his professional work. Dave Taylor is a commercial airline pilot. The advantage of being part of the industry would help fly his son to superior levels.
You know, one of the main perks of my dad being a pilot was that we could pretty much fly, you know, anywhere. And at that time, it was pretty easy to get on a plane on the weekend and just fly to, you know, Oklahoma for a tournament. There'd be times when he would just fly me, I'd fly down to Oklahoma for a weekend for a tournament and fly home.
And then that's how we found the Jack Roller series, which is out of Tulsa.
His very first match at his very first Tulsa Naturals, which I really believe is the toughest youth tournament, bar none, in the entire country, thanks to Jack Roller. The very first match, he had Dallas Bailey, who's ranked in some polls number one in the country right now at 160, and he was on the USA Dream Team that David just wrestled against. So his very first match was a kid of that caliber. Dad was a 2- or 3-time All-American at Oklahoma State, so obviously a wrestling family. And I think that was about the time that David just got hooked, and he goes, Dad, I got to do these.
And as I've gotten older, you know, I spent a lot of summers traveling around to different places to get with different people, different workout partners, getting different, you know, feels, different techniques, just different looks. And I've been exposed to a lot of really good people because of that.
And again, about third grade, David got invited by the Colin Palmer to come to the Jeff Jordan State Champ Camp here in Champaign County, St. Paris, Ohio. And we started becoming a regular, came in the summer, came back in the fall.
And so Elite Ohio Camps and David's gifted wrestling skills kept pointing him away from Wyoming, where his parents were now driving 4 hours round trip up to 3 days a week to match him with requisite practice competition.
They were good wrestlers from Wyoming, but once I got to where I was, you know, pretty good, the majority of the wrestling I did was in Utah.
David's very first coach in Evanston, Mike Lonsway, had done a superb job coaching David off his back and to the award stand. But ultimately, the opportunity would arise to move north to one of the rich primary hubs of high school wrestling, Ohio.
For Delta Airlines, Cincinnati was one of our bigger hubs. I started looking at a map and I go, man, we're already driving 100 miles for David to wrestle practice, one kid, 1 day a week or 2 days a week. I said, if we lived within 100 miles of Cincinnati, he could wrestle every day and I could just drive once a week to work. And I swear it wasn't about that time we're driving down the road and he goes, you know, Dad, wouldn't it be really cool if I could wrestle for Coach Jordan in high school? And the wheel started turning. I was thinking, you know, maybe we ought to just do that.
The Taylors' love for Wyoming's great outdoors moved with them to their new 45-acre Little Horse Farm in St. Paris, Ohio, where David would get his wish to wrestle for Graham High School, and younger sister Alex, an outstanding athlete, would become a state champion rider.
I wanted to provide them the lifestyle that I wanted as a kid, which is living on a farm or a ranch and having horses. And that's what we did. And both of my kids got into the horses and did real well. Just so happened David started wrestling.
David's wrestling legend grew quickly in Ohio, even before he landed at Graham High School. 3 junior high state titles in 6th, 7th, and 8th grade.
He leads 5-0 already. Taylor is just a buzzsaw.
At the outset of his freshman season,
you're looking at the baby-faced David Taylor, a freshman from St. Paris Graham.
2 tournaments would anchor his 4-year high school career. One would start the season, the other would close it. The first tournament of the regular wrestling season is in December. It's an elite national event called the Ironman.
Most important high school tournament in the country as far as wrestling goes.
To win 4, he would have to win as a freshman. David was the underdog.
He may be baby-faced, but he's a 3-time junior high state champion, and he's a cadet national champion in freestyle and Greco.
He seemed to stand little chance against an experienced, strong, number-one-seeded junior from California named Boris Novochkov.
That kid was a junior, and David was not even 100 pounds. That was nerve-wracking. I was nervous.
But look across the mat at Taylor. You're certainly not going to be scared to death.
Ever since I was little, I've never been the guy that's obviously, you know, really muscular, because that's just not how I'm built. And I've always been the kind of tall, lanky guy that, you know, has good technique. I think looks are a little deceiving. I don't think I'm, you know, as wimpy as I look. I think it's just, you know, nonstop. My plan is to go out there for 6 minutes and score as many points as I can.
As Mike said, I think a takedown wins. Oh. Good shot there by Taylor.
Oh,
see,
nice.
If he can finish, and he does.
There's never been a 4-time champ at the Ironman tournament.
And that's going to be it. David
nice.
Taylor.
That's awesome.
First Ironman visit, first championship. Great match.
And a chance to be the first 4-timer.
As a sophomore 103-pounder, going after his second Ironman title, experience was on his side. though he still had the baby face.
Taylor, still a very young looking boy, looks like 12 years old. Tremendous technique.
His finals opponent, a gifted freshman and a longtime friend.
Logan Stieber, our families are friends. That was more nerve-wracking than watching state.
2-1. And now the think that makes 3-2. Looking for back points
here. Taking that deep, there it goes.
And he's getting them. Seven, two.
Yep.
And David Taylor wins.
Still on track to be the first four-timer.
Now with two in a row, the count was on.
A legend, David Taylor, the junior, number one seed, number one in the country from Graham.
He would face Jamie Clark, the last wrestler to beat Taylor back in his sophomore season.
Oh.
Nice ankle pick
that's
there.
Nice. Uh-oh.
Clark's in trouble.
He'll be in real trouble if he's not careful here. Oh.
Taylor's starting to grow. He still facially looks about 12.
You know, laugh. Taylor emailed me at Cable 9 once for a copy of one of these and signed it, Babyface David Taylor.
Look at that. A try there by Clark. Taylor's just too long for him to hit those moves. That was a good move. It was well set up. It should have worked. But one thing you can't take for granted is the length that Taylor has.
And it's 7-1 now. That's going to lock up Taylor's third championship. Possibly in route to four.
He had three Ironman titles. And in each March of his freshman, sophomore, and junior year, he had gone to Columbus, and he had won the state title, too. So in March 2008, upon completing an undefeated junior season, three titles in a row in both the state and national Ironman, on top of the wrestling mountain where the advice is normally, don't change anything, relax and enjoy. How did he celebrate? David Taylor took aim on his senior year by moving up four weight classes.
Third state title.
About that time I decided, you know, Dad, I want to dedicate this summer to getting bigger, and I'm also 135 next year. And he looked at me and he's like, yeah, right.
He said, I'm going to Good Pastor, and he said, I'm going to get big, I'm going to go 135. And I laughed. I said, you weigh 125 right now, how in the heck are you going to get to 130? Those guys are going to be weighing 150, 160 cutting to 135. He said, I can do it.
In the spring of 2008, I received a phone call from David's father, Dave, and he said, hey, Coach Good Pastor, I want to send my kid to you so he can get stronger for his upcoming senior year. And that's how the collaboration began.
Well, I figured if Dustin Carter, who had no arms and no legs, could go to Scott Goodpaster and say, what do I need to do? Because I watched him wrestle. He was in David's weight for 2 years. Thank God he wasn't in David's weight last year because he was really tough. One thing that my son's brought up 100 times, and I believe it, Scott is as passionate about his lifting as I am about wrestling. And I think we really made a good pair.
Scott is able to give him individual attention. And we'll work on this right now. We're going to make this area stronger. We'll, you know, this is what we're going to do. And it's been great for David.
I sat at the state finals, David's freshman year, and I looked at my friend. I said, who is this kid? This kid's unreal. And he's only a freshman. And, you know, he won like, I think it was like 10-2 in the finals. And my friend was telling me all about David Taylor. And I'm like, man, I would love to train that kid one day. It came to fruition 3 years later.
It was the best decision probably I made my senior year. I got a lot stronger. Going down there, I drive an hour and 20 minutes, work out for an hour and 20 minutes, drive an hour and 20 minutes home. You know, for that drive, why would you go down there and not put all you can into that workout? You know, not only is it making me stronger, but the things that he was doing, I was getting me in better shape and, you know, just helping me become a more well-rounded athlete.
Come on, go. Alternate, side to side, just like that. Alternate. Come on, go hard. Come on. Circles. Come on, David. Come on. Done. One more round.
If you're gonna go in and dog it in practice and not work, you know, as hard as you can work, you're gonna have a hard time getting better.
I mean, David's so passionate that he wants to be the best, and I think passion integrates discipline. It integrates tenacity. It integrates a love for what you do. So when he's working out, he's just thinking like, I want to be the best. I don't want to be second best. And he just gives it everything he has. I can crush him at the beginning of the workout and throughout the workout. And he seems like he has more gas in the tank at the end.
Come on, buddy. Go. Come on.
Basically, if you always do what you always did, you always get what you always got. So you'll never get better. So I think you got to continuously push yourself to become a better wrestler and get better at different things to give yourself the best chance at being the best you can be.
Still, the conditioning and strength regimens had to be tested prior to the regular season. For that, he chose November 1st, 2008, Greensboro, North Carolina.
I decided that I was registered in the Super 32 tournament, which is the biggest preseason tournament in high school.
It's going to come to the end of the first period with a score of 0-0.
As we approached the Super 32, he was wrestling 135, so that's a big jump from 112. And I didn't doubt him at all.
Kendi goes up trying to catch him in a cradle. Ends up getting Taylor an escape in the first point of the match.
In this match, he was facing a future Pennsylvania state champion. David had a 1-0 lead going into the final period. During David's domination in the lighter weight classes, he had developed a unique style. One of his signature moves was the tilt, and began with the illusion that he was wrestling off his own back.
Well, I'm not technically wrestling off my back, you know, I'm not going my back to pin myself or anything like that, but I guess I'm a little bit of a risky wrestler, but it's the kind of stuff that I've kind of perfected, and everyone has their own style.
But his most prominent characteristic was an explosiveness often associated with high-octane, highly skilled fast-break basketball teams. Lethal scoring runs.
The thing about Taylor is he scores in bunches.
It doesn't look like he's doing a heck of a lot. He's got 14 points.
I remember going seeing Wilt Chamberlain play basketball one time at the old arena. And he didn't look like he was doing all that much. I mean, he was scoring. Turned out he had 63 points that game.
He just stalks you.
Don't look away, because David Taylor doesn't take long very often.
If I go out and do what I do best, which is score points, I'm a kid that goes out and I'm not really into pinning someone really fast. I go out and I score points, I get takedowns, I get turns, and I like to tech people. And I was real confident if I go out and do what I do best, which is put points on the scoreboard, there wasn't anyone that could beat me.
The way he wrestles, that's like magic to me. I mean, you can watch him wrestle and you blink your eye, he's already up 9-0. I mean, that's magic to me.
But back now to his preseason tune-up Super 32 title match. Holding a 1-0 lead, he would show there was as much grinded-out, blue-collar, heart and soul in his arsenal as there was magic, that he didn't need a huge lead. He could close out tight matches when necessary in the bigger, stronger weight class and on a national stage.
Taylor's going to ride it out in the third period. He's going to be a champion.
I actually remember telling my dad, I said, Dad, I think at 135, I think I could still, beat people. I think I can still probably, I think I'll have a lot closer match. I think I'll probably have more matches at 5-1. But I think I'm still going to be pretty good.
It kind of jumpstarts you, this is a great tournament, really good competition. I think it's definitely probably the toughest tournament of the year for me, with the exception of Ironman.
And Brian, history maybe tonight to start things off.
There's no question about it. No one has ever won 4 Ironman championships. And it's because it's such a wonderfully tough tournament. But tonight, David Taylor, kind of a wunderkind from freshman on, has a chance to do that at 135 pounds.
I jumped 4 weight classes from last year. So, that's what people are saying. I don't know if he can win 4. He was good when he was younger, all this stuff. And especially when they started saying that, that definitely was a big, a big motivator.
And David was wrestling his first match and went out there and got caught on his back. Which that didn't happen in high school. And he was down early, but came back. That's when I said, this kid is going to, he's going to have a great year because he never panicked.
Wow. His first one's always the hardest because he's not a morning person.
There were no other close calls. In the final, David would wrestle another future Pennsylvania State champion, Joe Waltko.
And a senior out of St. Paris, Graham, going after his fourth straight
pay for it.
I know I've been here too long because it seems like David was just winning this as a freshman and here it is a senior campaign.
I was just going to say the same thing. I was thinking, wasn't it last week that we were watching little David Taylor win the junior high state champs?
Which he did three
as
times,
a sixth
by
grader,
the way.
Yeah. He's not a big hitter either. I mean, he's got a hold near the record for technical falls.
Some points. And makes it 6-0. Oh my. 8-0.
That probably was one of my best shots of the year. Just kind of hit a nice little, kind of duck under high crotch right as he was reaching and kind of disappeared behind him, I guess you could say. And it was, that was a fun takedown, I guess. You know, this time in the match, I was feeling pretty good. I was feeling pretty confident that, you know, I was kind of in the driver's seat. I was just having fun, just had to make sure I didn't do anything stupid.
What'd you write down for him? What's the first thing you wrote, Mike?
For Taylor.
Yep.
Tough everywhere. 10-1 now. Well, the second thing I wrote down was that he was ready for college wrestling last year.
Brian, has pressure ever got to Taylor ever? I mean, he looked like this in sixth grade winning against eighth grader.
85 seconds from being the first four-time Ironman champ.
Probably a standing O from this crowd.
Looking for some tilt points. There it is.
First one. I think it's the best kid I ever watched.
He's certainly in the top five of all time, I think. Probably the most decorated national wrestler in terms of cadet championships, junior championships. I'll tell you, David Taylor has won everything. About the only thing he hasn't won is this tournament four times in a row, and he did it easily during this tournament. Even though he's up four weight classes, he's one in a thousand, one in a million, one in a 100 million maybe. He's a sensational wrestler.
It was pretty hard to imagine at the time that I was going to be a four-time Ironman champ just because thinking about all the good people that came through that tournament and, you know, hadn't done that.
With the four national titles won and the state meet still several months off, David set his sights on an extraordinary mid-season challenge, a dual meet Saturday, January 24th versus St. Edward High School.
I guess it was the week before he wrestled St. Ed's. And, I told Dad that I was going to talk to Coach Jordan about wrestling Colin Palmer. And he was pretty surprised that, you know, he's like, really? I said, yeah, I'm going to go up and talk to him on the way home today.
Like David, Colin Palmer was a three-time Ohio State champion. But even a moment when life imitates a Hollywood script needs the support of his coach and team. His famous coach, Jeff Jordan, was initially caught off guard by the request.
And he's like, really? And I said, yeah, I want to do it. He goes, wow. He kind of sat back for a second.
But Coach Jordan, the Ironman Coach of the Year in 2008, and himself a four-time Ohio State champion, recovered gracefully and thoughtfully upon the rarest of requests to move up another weight class, David's fifth in a year, to face a fellow reigning three-time state champion.
I told him, I said, you know, Coach, I think there's probably, you know, there's a 50-50 chance. I think that there's, you know, I could win or I could lose. But I want to do it. I think it'd be good for the sport and good for Ohio. People never do this. People never bump up a weight class to wrestle another good kid, especially when there's two kids that are going for their four state titles. You know, that's never happened. I'd like to talk to the team. I'd say, you know, if you guys, there's a chance that we could lose the duel. You know, if I go out there and if I lost, there could be a chance. You know, the duel could be pretty tight, and you know, see what they have to say about it. And he goes, Coach said he was fine with it. He goes, let me call Matt Stevens up here because Matt Stevens was our 40-pounder. And we talked to him, and he said, you know, Matt, Dave wants to go up this weekend and wrestle Palmer. What do you think? And he says, I think I want him to do it. I think it would be really awesome. And in doing so, Matt decided to cut down to 135 because he had certified at 135 that year, and which is really something pretty awesome. That kind of says a lot about our team, it's, you know, how one guy will cut down a weight class for another guy to go up a weight.
Quick snap and run around. Palmer takes an early 2-point lead.
Got a real quick takedown, but you know, I was pretty confident that going into the match that my conditioning would, you know, play a factor. This is where he reverses me. He does exactly, reaches my bottom leg, elevates it, and scoots his hips off. So that, you know, at that point I'm down 4-1, and you know, Mr. Palmer's in the background, jumping up and down, which is pretty funny. He was pretty intense, but you know, right now is. He's a really good leg rider, but you know, I'm really confident on the bottom position when guys put their legs in, and I knew I'd reverse them right here. And you know, this was a big swing in the match. You know, it goes from 4-1 to 4-3, and you know, Colin Palmer just got reversed, you know, from the legs, and that's what the Palmers are known for, is throwing the legs in. So that was pretty big in the match. You know, I don't think he gets reversed very often. You know, it was a really big crowd, and I don't think it was, you know, really, you know, I don't think it was favored one guy over the other. It was just, you know, they just wanted to see a really good match. So third period, I went down, he's got an escape, so we tied up 4-4. And right there, he tried a shuck, and I caught his far leg on the shuck, and finished with a double leg for a takedown. So I took the lead 6-4. But you know, right here is when I get a turn. Talked about rolling across my back. I got a cross wrist and roll him across, you know, and elevate him to his back, my bottom leg. You know, right there. I got my takedown in the third period, my back points in the third period, and, you know, that's what I kind of thought I needed. About 8 seconds left. I just let him go. And it was just an awesome feeling. It was so loud, like I couldn't hear myself think. It was just echoing in there, and it was that was the best moment. You know, if I had to go back and save my life, that was probably the best moment of my life. Just, you know, the crowd, just that I finally kind of accomplished something that, you know, no one else had really, you know, no one else probably had accomplished in high school. You know, probably the biggest match. You know, this is actually right there is when they started chanting that David Taylor again. I can't really describe, you know, the feeling of, you know, all my friends right there. Just, it was just awesome.
Graham won the dual meet that night, 37-22. By the time the state meet rolled around in March, David Taylor was 44-0, four matches from a perfect season, and his number one objective of a fourth state title.
The week of state, around Wednesday, he didn't talk to anybody. Just leave me alone, Mom. What do you want? Leave me alone. Okay, you know, and that's kind of how it is.
At every tournament, I think, okay, this is the last home dual meet. This is the last sectionals. This is the last districts. This is the last state.
One of the greatest wrestlers in Ohio history, that's David Taylor, one of the greats of all time. And he'll be going up against Manuel Cintron from Alliance.
David Taylor doesn't take long very often.
I finally got to meet his father before this match. Very nice gentleman. And he said, well, hopefully David has one more in him. I said, I don't think we have to worry too much about that.
David is 15-0 at the state meets. 14 of those ended in less than 6 minutes.
Only one wrestler has ever gone 6 minutes with them, and that was Kyle Gilchrist when they were freshmen. It was only 10-2 score. And Taylor with some more points here.
It's hard to believe that the babyface assassin's not going to be around again.
That's right.
Probably a question that didn't need to be asked was, I saw early on in one of the blogs saying, will David Taylor be as good at 135 as he was at 103 and 112? And 9-1, and more back points.
I think wherever
great wrestlers look good at every weight class.
I was
going to
say, I don't think it matters what weight class he chooses. He's going to look good at any of them.
That's three more. It's 12-1. We still have 20 seconds to go in the first period.
This kid is just so fluid. You turn around and turn around again, he may have scored 8 points.
An interesting move here. Taylor actually took the top position.
Get more points. That might be it.
That's 15-1.
That's
one more turn here. And this is it.
You know what?
He went up. Might pin him.
Yeah. What a way to finish your career in high school. He ain't gonna let him go.
That's the fall.
It is. Exclamation point.
2 minutes and 39 seconds. Standing out for David Taylor.
Well deserved.
Well, I think I speak for all of us in saying thank you, David. It was a pleasure to watch you over the last 4 years.
It went fast.
I thought it was kind of cool when he was on the mat and he's like hitting his headgear like, oh my gosh, I really did this. It was like it finally clicked with him that he actually accomplished this.
You know, I was thinking about it all week, you know, what would happen if I won. And, a lot of people plan to do some, stupid things, and the only thing I could do was just smile and then see my dad and my mom and think how hard I've worked and how much they've dedicated their lives to help me, get to where I am. And I got to thank them and then turn around and see Coach Jordan and all the things that he's done for me every day since I've gotten to high school. And I can't thank them enough for everything that they've done for me.
It was pretty awesome. I've been with him for so long. We used to all go as a family, but it got to the point where my daughter had her activities going, and so a lot of times it was just he and I. And I can remember one year we went to they called this tournament the Ironman. It was freestyle, Greco, and folk style all in the same weekend back in Michigan. And he lost to a kid, and I must have been the ugly American dad, because, boy, I chewed him out the whole way back to the hotel and told him it was a waste of a Memorial Day weekend. And all those things go through your mind, how much of a complete idiot you were, but then for the kid to still come up and hug you and tell you thanks was really pretty amazing.
This year, it was just really neat to see him do that, and he just felt so good the whole time. He didn't have any aches and pains. He felt really strong.
David was the 17th wrestler to win 4 Ohio State titles. He was the first to win 7, 3 in junior high. He beat the state 140-pound champion, his good friend Colin Palmer, to that honor by one weight class.
When you go on the award stand, the announcer goes through, your record and, your 17th, 4-time state champion. When you watch it and then once you actually hear it and you're the person on that stand, it's completely different. You can watch them like that every day, but until you actually experience it, you don't realize, what it's really like.
And Ohio is the 17th four-time state champion from Sisters Greco, senior David Taylor.
The youngest Taylor, Alex, played a vital role too. She is also a state champion.
But I'm big into the barrels and the poles.
In terms of athletic ability, she's got way more athletic ability than I do. And I think that she's gonna be really successful in whatever she does in life. And she's a great, great support. To think all the years that she'd go to tournaments and sit there and watch me go and all this kind of stuff. And at the time, you don't really think about it. But when you think back, you're just like, how many sisters go and watch a tournament all day long or a weekend, a whole weekend long, You know, a lot of sacrifices were made for her to come and watch me. Not going with her friends and that kind of stuff, and I really appreciate that.
He's a good student, and I want to continue being a good student. He works hard and manages schoolwork and wrestling. I can see big stuff for him. Like, he's such a hard worker, and he just strives to be the best, so I'm excited to watch him in college.
She will watch him at Penn State, where he will wrestle for a legendary coach, Cale Sanderson.
He was my idol growing up, still is my idol, the way he wrestled, the way he was nonstop, just always scoring points.
Sanderson is perhaps the greatest wrestler in American history. A 2004 Olympic champion, he went undefeated 4 years of college wrestling, 159-0, winning four consecutive NCAA titles from 1999 through 2002.
To think that to attack my goals with him is, pretty awesome. And who better do it with than someone that's done it himself? He's the only guy that's won four national titles and been undefeated, and he was an Olympic champ. He's done everything.
I just see a lot of potential in David, and I know he's had just unbelievable success up to this point. But when I recruit kids, I look for kids that are going to be successful in college and beyond, not who was great in high school. And I really believe David is just getting started in his career. I think he's just starting to tap into his potential.
But prior to Penn State, David still had more national high school achievements to register. ASICS named him first team All-American and the National High School Wrestler of the Year. In June 2009, David was named winner of the prestigious Dave Schultz Excellence Award. It is presented by the National Wrestling Hall of Fame and Museum and awarded to one high school wrestler. Its recipient is evaluated on rigorous standards of excellence in wrestling, character, citizenship, community service, and scholastic achievement. David graduated with a GPA of over 3.9.
Right around this time when the Dave Schultz would come out, all the year-end awards, I would look through the magazines and look at all names and hope maybe one day I'd be that guy in the magazine. So when I found out about it, I kind of had a flashback to when I was a kid looking at those magazines and that I was the looking at that could be myself, So it was awesome. To be on the same list as all those wrestlers that have won it previously, it's a really prestigious group of individuals. So hopefully I can accomplish some of the same things that they accomplished.
180 wins and 2 losses. David, what happened?
I got lucky, I guess.
As a 10-year-old, David had visited the Hall of Fame with his father as interested fans and tourists. Less than 10 years later, David is displayed inside as a renowned honoree. His future success will determine if he is elected and inducted with the pantheon of distinguished members, but his immediate sights are set on Coach Sanderson, Penn State, and the Olympic Games.
He's a guy that's self-motivated. He's a guy that knows what he wants. He has his goals. He's determined. He's focused, and he's talented.
But I think for him to realize his potential, he needs to be with Cale Sanderson, because he's the greatest there is. And some people consider David the best mat wrestler that ever came out of the state of Ohio. Cale's with arguably the best ever on his feet. So you take a guy that's the best on his feet, the guy that's best on the mat, and you put those two into one kid that's really hungry, I think success is there.
I wish him all the luck, I really do. And I don't want to say this is what I project. I just, knowing David, he'll probably get his job done because that's what he likes to do. He's real goal-oriented.
I dedicated my life, since I can remember, to the sport of wrestling. There were times when I would not go out with my friends. There were, not go out and do what everyone else is doing, and dedicate my life to the practice room. I mean, there's a difference between being a wrestler and living the sport of wrestling. The guy that goes to practice every day, or the guy that goes to practice and then thinks about practice and then goes back and drills and really goes into practice trying to get better. If you really want to live your life the way that it needs to be to be a good wrestler, then that's what I did.
I'm half raising a rope,
Taylor also strong, you know. He was the assassin, never could get past him. He killed and teletect, it seems, all part of his message. Seemed like he knew where. He looked right to where, yeah. Come on home now, he said with a smile. You won't be around long as we wrestle for a while. So try to understand him, try to understand him. Try to understand. He's a magic man. Stop sign after stop sign, he won them with a smile. Four straight state titles, he fed opponents with his style. So try to understand him, try to understand him. Try to understand him, try to understand him. His baby face assassin. Try to understand. He's a magic man. With a smile, you won't be around long as we wrestle for a while. But try to understand him, try to understand him. Try to understand. He's an Iron Man state champion. Oh. He's a magic man.
I'm sure we'll see him again.